Now we're going to show you a little bit of this complexity, and the big question that we're going to is, where did this information come from? If you're starting from zero, could this information have come about by chance? Natural selection. All right, so let's watch this animation, and I want you to see this. Watch.
With computer animation, we can enter the cell to view this remarkable system at work. After entering the heart of the cell, we see the tightly wound strands of DNA, storehouses for the instructions necessary to build every protein in an organism. In a process known as transcription, a molecular machine first unwinds a section of the DNA helix to expose the genetic instructions needed to assemble a specific protein molecule. Another machine then copies these instructions to form a molecule known as messenger RNA. When transcription is complete, the slender RNA strand carries the genetic information through the nuclear pore complex, the gatekeeper for traffic in and out of the cell nucleus. The messenger RNA strand is directed to a two-part molecular factory called a ribosome. After attaching itself securely, the process of translation begins. Inside the ribosome, a molecular assembly line builds a specifically sequenced chain of amino acids. These amino acids are transported from other parts of the cell and then linked into chains often hundreds of units long. Their sequential arrangement determines the type of protein manufactured. When the chain is finished, it is moved from the ribosome to a barrel-shaped machine that helps fold it into the precise shape critical to its function. After the chain is folded into a protein, it is then released and shepherded by another molecular machine to the exact location where it is needed.
All right, folks, that's just one cell. All those little parts are in just one cell, and information is king. Information is controlling all of those different parts. It's even more complex than what Stephen just showed you here. Stephen, where did this information come from?
Well, that's the $64,000 question, as they used to say. I call it the DNA enigma. And the DNA enigma is not, what is the structure of DNA? Watson and Crick solve that mystery. It's not even, what does the information do? We've just seen it in the animation. The question is, where did the information come from? And there's two basic answers. Either the information arose through purely undirected, unguided, purposeless material processes, or it's the product of some kind of designing intelligence, in what we call intelligent design. Those were the two options, and that's what I set out to investigate as I became fascinated with this question in the mid-1980s.
This has been an ATRI production.